I think agroforestry is a return to the old ways. We've sort of been disconnected from nature in a lot of the ways that we get our food, energy, water. My name is Nathan Ayers. I'm the project lead for the West Michigan Agroforestry Partnership. We're here at Kropscott Environmental Farm, located in Newaygo County, about 30 miles inland from Lake Michigan.
The Kropscott Farm Environmental Center was donated to us by the Kropscott family about 25 years ago. The role that we play is we have developed it into an educational facility. In the last year, we have educated about 1,400 students out here in various areas of natural resource management and environment with an emphasis on agriculture and wildlife.
And I think agroforestry provides a really sound roadmap for us to be able to reintegrate our agricultural systems with natural processes, the ecosystems, and the aquifers that supply our farms. A couple of months into our project, we were really fortunate to meet Bill Boer. Bill is a longtime farmer here in the region. He's been practicing a type of agriculture akin to agroforestry, only he didn't call it that. It's just kind of the model that he developed using cows and trees.
We're homesteaders originally, farming for 50 years. I say organic before there was certification. I'm Bill Boer. This is Earthscape Farm. We're in Oceana County on the west side of the Lower Peninsula of Michigan. It will never be exactly as you think it's going to be. It's always evolving as it goes. I mean, this was not our plan, but that's the way it ended up. I'm afraid too many people see nature through a screen. And we try and work with kids because there is a nature deficit disorder. You know, you gotta love it when kids catch tadpoles and the water goes over the top of their boots.
Finding people like Bill is really critical to our project success. He's an elder in this community. He's been doing it for decades. And although agroforestry might be a really neat sort of roadmap for what we can do, Bill is the person who's been walking along that road and can answer a lot of specific questions about what actually works on the ground, particularly when we get into pasture mixes, seed mixes, different types of tree crops, and what the animals are going to respond well to. We're in a unique situation here where the farmer that's going to be grazing animals on this property lives just across the street. And so Andy Morin is the farmer from Morin Family Farms, and he's really excited to be able to experiment with what we're designing in Silvopasture. He's seen the light a little bit in terms of the need for change in the way that conventional animals are farmed. He's really excited to have different types of fodder for his animals to eat, some shade that's really valuable for his cows. And it's exciting to get to work with farmers that have been doing things a certain way for a number of years but are open-minded to trying new methodologies like silvopasture and agroforestry.
You know, when I got involved with the Newaygo Soil Conservation District, we got talking about soil and how much topsoil has been robbed over the years. And there's a problem. And as a farmer, and used to be a row crop farmer, you can really tell there's a problem and we need to change. I'm Andy Morin. We are standing at the Kropscott Environmental Center in Newaygo County, Fremont, Michigan. I feel since we've seeded this down, it's changed already. Just look at the grass we have here established, the trees that are going to be coming. We're not taking from the soil anymore. Like the change has started here.